in a way, I would begin by trying to appreciate the path that the military high command is taking to try and connect with the elders and community leaders of the people of Wa, and to begin to make right what has been violated in terms of the abuse of innocent civilians. And to that extent, one would want to present the argument beginning from that point. But I must quickly add, my good sister, and this goes in line with what a lawyer, Martin Kwegbu, has been presenting. The military get away with impunity, and so they will continue to be indisciplined and unprofessional, as we saw them beating people in the Upper West regional capital, Wa. I say this because when Ghanaians were horrified to see the military shoot on civilians in Techiman South, the military said they were going to investigate and deal with the circumstances that led to the killing of innocent, or let me put it, Ghanaians who were agitating around issues related to elections. What happened to their own actions of internal investigations? And so one would immediately concede that whatever they decide to do, the public has the right to know the internal disciplinary measures they will take. And not just to say it is going to be internal and they have taken actions against the perpetrators of these abuses and it ends there. Ghanaians would have a right to know what exactly happened. But over and above that, the military need to bring back professionalism and discipline in the operations of the Ghana Armed Forces. And this they need to do comprehensively. They need to reset the clock and make their men and women understand their roles as an armed forces and take away the pervasive brutality that has always been an image of the army. And when people thought that was put backwards, we then see it recurring. And for them to do this, they have to interrogate themselves with a very important question. Why is there such an environment that is pervasive of violence and the use of violence each time there is an incident that requires to be taken care of? Why is there a climate that makes people to love using violence, particularly as a professional agency in trying to resolve issues? And I think that's where we need to take the argument from, so that the responsibility is both the discipline of the individuals who are perpetrators, but also collective in ensuring that we have a military that serves the purposes of deepening and consolidating Ghana's democratic practice, and not what we have seen, which was so unfortunate yesterday in Wa.